Hello and welcome to another tier list video. Today we are taking a look at board games. Now, I compiled all the board games that I've played a bunch of times as a kid, and I enjoy each of these games for a different reason, but some of them definitely more than others. So, starting us off, we have Candyland. Now, this game is really pretty standard. You have your board, it's covered with different colors, and you pretty much draw cards from a deck, and you know that determines how far you go ahead. And overall, I would say the game is fun, but it's definitely more of a basic game. Definitely the kind of game that's good if you're, hanging out with little kids who can't really, understand or comprehend some of the more complicated games that I think are a little more entertaining. But it's still a pretty good game, even though it's pretty basic, but it doesn't have a whole lot to offer somebody who's looking to have, a little bit more of a mental challenge. So Candyland will find itself in the C tier. Definitely has its use cases, but not so much as you get older. Up next, we have Battleship. Now, I like Battleship because it combines a fair amount of luck with strategy. The luck element is usually, guessing where the enemy's ships are, but there is a bit of strategy in terms of setting up your ships. And if you know the other person likes to set up their ships in a certain way, whether it's on the corners or in the center, you can use that to your advantage. And Battleship, it's okay. It's nothing super special, but it's a fun game to play with just two people. There's not a whole lot of board games that are really fun if you have just two people, but Battleship is definitely one of those that you can do with just two people, and for that reason, Battleship is going to find itself in the B tier. Up next, we have Monopoly. Now, Monopoly as a game, I really enjoy it. That being said, the board game version of Monopoly, I'm not really a huge fan of because the games take so long. It takes so long to count out the money, to hand it out. I honestly can't remember the last time I actually finished a game of Monopoly that was the board game version. That being said, playing Monopoly on my phone or on another gaming console where all the transactions are done instantly and for you, I enjoy that a lot more because you can knock out a game of Monopoly with four people in 30, 40 minutes, sometimes an hour. But if you're playing it out of the box with the physical board, I have played Monopoly for 2.5 hours and still not finished the game. So for that reason, I don't love the board game version of Monopoly, but I still really like the game itself. So it honestly would be an S tier because it's one of my favorite games on this list. But for the sheer reason that it's almost impossible for me to finish it if I have a physical copy, Monopoly is only going to find itself in the A tier. Still a solid pick, but I definitely prefer to play digital versions of it. Up next, we have Ticket to Ride. Now, this is a pretty unique game. If you haven't played it before, I recommend giving it a try. That being said, the first time or two that you play the game, it's really not that much fun because you have no idea what you're doing and you kind of just get destroyed in comparison to the other people if they know what they're doing. But after a couple games, it's pretty fun. It's a solid one to play with your friends. Definitely not a game you can really play with littler kids because the ideas and strategies are a bit more complex, but still a fun game. So Ticket to Ride will find itself in the B tier. Up next, we have Settlers of Catan. This is honestly probably my favorite game on the list. I really enjoy this game. It's not super complicated, pretty easy to learn, but there's a lot of good strategy, and every time you play, the board is different. And I've just had a lot of fun playing with friends. It's a pretty casual game, not super competitive. One you can just play and have a conversation with someone as well. But Catan, overall, just such a fun game, so much strategy, and really enjoy it a lot. So Settlers of Catan, gonna be S tier. Definitely my favorite one on the list. Up next, we have Chutes and Ladders. Now, this game is pretty similar to Candyland in terms of the fact that you're pretty much just traversing through a board, trying to be the first one to the end. But instead of drawing, different colors from a deck like in Candyland, Chutes and Ladders has a spinner. But of course, as the name hints at, there's chutes that send you down and ladders that send you up. So it's a game that has a lot of luck because you can be almost at the end of the board and then hit one of those chutes and slide all the way down back to almost the beginning. Can definitely be an infuriating game, but a great game to play if you're playing with younger kids. So pretty much hits all the same points as Candyland for me, so it's also going to find itself in the C tier. Up next, we have Chess. Now, chess is a really fun game. That being said, it's only really fun if you have two people who are fairly ma evenly matched. If you have someone who's just way better at chess than the other person, it's not really that interesting. But if you do have people who are fairly evenly matched, I think chess is a lot of fun. I personally still love playing chess. But you really have to know your opponent and have to have somebody who is gonna give each other a challenge, because if it's just one person dominating, it's not gonna be that fun. So chess, I love it. Probably my second favorite game on the list, but just because of the restrictions in terms of trying to find an evenly matched opponent if you're not playing online, it can be difficult, so chess will find itself in the A tier. Up next, we have Yahtzee. I think Yahtzee is a pretty good game. I honestly can't tell you the last time I played it. It's probably been 3 or 4 years, but it's a pretty good game. A lot of luck involved, but it's always fun to yell Yahtzee. Don't have too much to say about that one. Gonna be in the B tier. Up next, we have Jenga. Jenga is a pretty fun game all around. You know, you can play with someone from pretty much any age group, really. You know, young kids can understand it, but adults also, you know, they're able to get the Jenga pieces out. They can know which ones are not gonna make it collapse. And you know, it's a pretty solid game. Nothing spectacular, but just a fun game. So we're gonna find itself in the B tier. Up next, we have Sorry. Now this is another one that's pretty luck-based, but there definitely is some skill with deciding which one of your pieces to move forward across the board. And Sorry honestly used to be one of my favorite games as a kid. I still really enjoy it. It's a good one. You can play with kids or adults. Still fun. Sorry, gonna find itself in the A tier. Up next, we have Kerplunk. Now this is a game that I used to love as a kid. I honestly have not played it in probably close to 10 years, but basically, you stick a bunch of spokes in this little container, and then you pour a bunch of marbles on it, and you basically take turn pulling out straws. It's kind of like Jenga in that sense. And then whoever pulls out the straw that causes all the marbles to fall, that's the person who loses the game. So kind of like Jenga, you're trying to pull things out without breaking the structure. But I think it's a little more fun than Jenga actually, personally. There's a bit of strategy and a bit of luck involved. It's just overall a pretty fun game. It's gonna find itself in the A tier. Up next, we have Life. Now, Life is another game that's pretty good, but that being said, I feel like half the time when I play Life, the game is decided near the beginning of the game when you're picking your jobs, because if you get a really good job, you pretty much got the game in the bag, which I suppose is similar to real life. So it's pretty realistic in that sense. That being said, I don't love Life. It's a good game, but not one of my favorites. It'll find itself in probably a low B tier. Up next, we have Operation, a game that I loved playing as a kid, but now if I play it, it's honestly just kind of easy. You know, when you're a kid and your motor skills are more comparable to that of a monkey, Operation is a fun, challenging game, but as an adult, it's a little too easy. So at this point, I'm not a huge fan of Operation. This might upset some people, but it's actually gonna find itself in the D tier. Up next, we have Hungry Hungry Hippo. This is another game that I really liked as a kid. Now I realize just how mindless it is. You know, you pour the marbles in, the board is vibrating, everybody's slamming down their hippo mouth, and it's pretty much just luck to for wherever the marbles go. That's just who wins. You know, if you have a lot of marbles come towards you, your hippo gets to eat a lot and you win. It's not really a whole lot of skill in terms of when you open the hippo's mouth. Sure, there's a little bit there, but it usually if you just slam your hippo a bunch of times, you might end up winning anyway. So Hungry Hungry Hippo is actually also going to find itself in the D tier for me. Up next, we have Connect 4. I think this is a great game because you can play this game as a kid or play it as an adult and still win or lose either way. There's a little bit of luck involved in Connect 4, but mostly it's just skill and strategy, and I think it's pretty good in that sense. You know, it's kind of like a watered down version of chess or checkers. Definitely more strategy there, but if you know what you're doing in Connect 4, you can win pretty much any time. But I still enjoy a game of Connect 4 here and there, so it'll find itself in the B tier. Up next, we have Trouble. Now, this game is relatively similar to Sorry in terms of you have multiple pieces, you're trying to get them all at the end, you can choose which ones to move forward. But instead of drawing cards from a deck, you're pushing a button. And I would say this game is just a slightly simpler version of Sorry. And, you know, if I had to choose between the two, I'm probably just going to choose Sorry every time because I think there's a little more strategy, a little more entertainment value in Sorry, but Trouble, still a solid game. It'll find itself in the B tier. Up next, we have Scattergories. I absolutely love Scattergories. Honestly, up with Catan and Monopoly, this is one of my favorite games to play, even today. Definitely not really one you can play with younger kids because they're going to struggle to come up with answers for all the categories. But Scattergories, I think, is a great game. Love playing it. I honestly played Scattergories about a month ago. Definitely a solid game. Gonna find itself in the S tier. Well, let me know your guys' thoughts. Let me know any board games that you guys would have wanted to see included or that you enjoyed playing as a kid that I haven't played. And, you know, maybe I'll give it a try. Hope you guys enjoy it.